Hey everybody, Kevin at Woodcraft here, and today we're going to make one of these rocking pizza cutters using our WoodRiver 16-inch rocking pizza cutter kit. That's right, this beast is 16 inches long, 4 inches tall, and made of food-grade stainless steel. The kit is designed to allow you to make one long continuous handle or two separate smaller handles. If you're doing the two handles, we recommend about 4 inches each. Either way, you'll want to start with a workpiece that's around 1.5 inches square. So let's get started. First thing is safety. These come sharp, so make sure you cover that edge with a few layers of painter's tape. Now we're going to use a thin curved blade to cut a slot down the center of our workpiece that's 7/8 inches deep. Now before we go resetting anything, we're going to do a test fit, and you can see this is way too tight. So I'm not going to change anything on my saw, I'm just going to run the workpiece over the blade again, and you can see it fits much better this time. Next, we need to make a line on the outside of the blank that corresponds with the depth of that cut. We're going to use this to align the blade and make sure we drill our holes in the right spots. We'll use some double stick tape to temporarily attach the blade to the workpiece and use that as a guide to drill our holes. I'm drilling 4 millimeter holes all the way through the blank because I'm just going to use some 4 millimeter brass pins, I think. If you're using the included fasteners, you will also need to counterbore some 6 millimeter holes for the heads of the fasteners. Now we need to shape it. And you can do this before or after you attach the workpiece to the blade. But you want to make sure you have a plan in mind, because if you want to shape the bottom of that workpiece, it might be a little hard once it's attached to the blade. After I drilled the holes, I realized they're really weighted to the bottom of the workpiece, and it's not going to work with the idea that I had in my head. So I grabbed another piece, repeated all the steps up to this point, but didn't drill any holes in it. Then I set my table saw to 45 degrees and cut off the corners to make a hexagon shape. And then I used the crosscut sled to bevel the ends at 45 degrees as well. Since I'm skipping the pins, I use some sandpaper to rough up the blank a little bit to give the epoxy a little bit better hold. And to keep things a little cleaner, I've added painter's tape to the ends of the workpiece as well as across that saw curve. Then we'll mix up the epoxy and use a little popsicle stick to help spread it in the workpiece. I tried to modify my design a little bit to work with the original workpiece, and I just didn't really like how it turned out, so it became a test piece for finishes. And I thought I wanted to maybe add a little bit of color to this oak, but of course I ended up going with some plain Osmo Pollock soil. And I actually liked this design so much that I ended up making a second one using the bird's eye maple with bark inclusions that we had a while back, and I think it turned out gorgeous. Now we just need to find a pizza and test it out. I find this a lot easier to use than traditional pizza cutters because the force is concentrated over the center of the blade. If you like this video and want to stay up to date on the latest in the woodcraft shop, be sure to subscribe to our channel. If you want to pick up one of these kits or anything else you saw in this video, head over to your local woodcraft store or online to woodcraft.com.